Hello everyone, guys. Now we are moving on to the next exercise. Very simple again, and one of the most important exercise or a warm-up drills, especially for a combat sports. It doesn't matter if you wrestle, if you grapple, if you're doing MMA, BJJ, boxing even. It's very important to warm up your neck, and I'll just run you through a quick drill how you do that with most of our students, which they have participated in some of the wrestling classes. We have done this exercise before we start performing. So the way you do it, you can do it anywhere, even without a mat. You can do it on the grass later on. So from here, put your forehead down and go forward, backward, left, right. So make sure you focus on all parts of the neck. Once you've done all directions, forward, backwards, left, right, you can go a couple deep circles towards your right shoulder, and then change few deep circles towards your left shoulder. Make sure you go really deep so you can affect all the shoulder blade, all the neck, so it's a proper stretch. Few times left, few times right. Once you've done that, increase the weight of the on the neck. So from here, how do you do it? Knees off the ground, open up your legs as much as you can, and keep moving, same motion, forward, backwards, left, right, forward, backwards, left, right. Couple rotations towards the right shoulder, and then change few deep rotations towards the left shoulder. If you want to put a little bit extra weight, lock your hands behind your back and keep moving left and right at the same time. Move forward, left and right, come backwards. If it's too difficult for you to keep the hands behind your back, try to lock it behind your knees or your ankles. Once you've done this motion, now the neck is getting warmer, you can move up to a headstand. The way you do it, form a triangle, keep your hands on one line, the head goes always a little bit further, knees off the ground, baby steps towards your head, slowly come up. If you haven't done it before, back down, try it a couple of times, up and down. If you've done it before, come all the way up, leg straight up in the air, open up the legs to the side of you, try to rotate in a couple of times, left and right. After that, you can do a little bit biking. Let me turn around so I can see you. You can do a little bit biking. If there is a crowd around, you can do some claps for the crowd. Once you've done this, then you can move on to the specialist way, or for those of you who are professionals. So from here, next level is move forward, backwards, forward, backwards. That's the best way to get your neck stronger. Once you've done forwards, backwards, you can do a couple of times left and right, and then you can do couple deep circles towards your right shoulder, and then change few deep circles towards your left shoulder. Once you've done this motion, guys, you can do a soft landing from here. Don't keep the legs straight and drop, bend them, and then gently drop, make with your body like an arch, go to a bridge position. Or if that is too difficult for you, you can just lay down on your back without dropping from the headstand and bridge from here. Go for 5 bridges, 10 bridges, it depends which level you are. So from here, go forward, aim to touch your nose on the mat, and back, touch your shoulders. Forward, touch your nose, come back, touch your shoulders 5 to 10 times. Once you've done that motion, guys, next one, lock your hands on your chest. Do 3 to 4 bridges without touching the hands on the floor, so it's a little bit heavier. Those of you who are more flexible, try to kiss the mat or touch your chin on the mat. Go as deep as you can. Okay. Once you've done that motion, next one is the flip. So from here, get some speed. Now the flip, guys, is more technical. It's not about physical, it's very skillful, this one. So once you've learned how to bridge, get some speed, do not look up the sky, do not look in front of you, try to see what's underneath your head, imagine what's underneath and try to see it, get some speed, and then once you're moving forward, at the same time one of your leg goes up, and then you flip over. And back. And back. And back. And back. If you're struggling to do that, you can start for any exercise or for any move, there is some breaking points which you can do before it. So from here, specifically for the flip over, you can just start from a partial position, flip over, walk around, flip again, walk around, flip again, and then once you open up the rust in your hips, then you can choose one of the sides. The knee points that direction. So from here, the knee points to the direction which you're gonna flip. The elbow is almost down, and just drop over. Kinda get used to it. Help get used to it. And every other time, try to flip higher and higher until you achieve the flip. Okay, I'll leave it to it. And guys, look, it's not necessary to do the full circuit. Do some bridges at first, or just some movement of the neck. Even if you're just sitting down and going left, right, rotation, left and right, it's still something. Hope you're well, and looking forward to catching up soon. Thanks for watching.